This video examines the maternal mortality ratio in most DHS surveys conducted since late 2015. The maternal mortality ratio, or MMR, is the number of maternal deaths per 100,000 live births. What counts as a maternal death? The World Health Organization, or WHO, defines maternal deaths as deaths of women while pregnant, during childbirth, or within 42 days of delivery or termination of pregnancy. Maternal deaths are deaths from any cause except accidents or acts of violence. To learn about the differences between maternal and pregnancy-related mortality in DHS surveys, check out our video comparing these two measures. There are four important things to know about the maternal mortality ratio. First, the maternal mortality ratio has a reference period. A reference period is the time frame for which survey respondents are asked to report activities or experiences of interest. The maternal mortality ratio often examines maternal deaths in the 7-year period before the survey. But some DHS surveys have used other reference periods for this indicator. The reference period will be stated in the final report table that presents MMR estimates. Second, the maternal mortality ratio is not the same as the maternal mortality rate. The maternal mortality ratio is the number of maternal deaths during the reference period per 100,000 live births in the same reference period. The maternal mortality rate is the number of maternal deaths during the reference period per 1,000 women age 15 to 49. The maternal mortality ratio compares maternal deaths to births of children. In contrast, the maternal mortality rate compares maternal deaths to the number of women age 15 to 49. Third, DHS uses information about the survival of sisters to measure maternal mortality. Women interviewed in DHS surveys are asked to list their siblings, that is, all the children born to their mother. Women are then asked about the survival status of all their siblings. In the case of female siblings who have died at age 12 or older, the interviewer asks whether or not the sister died during pregnancy, childbirth, or within the 2 months following delivery or end of pregnancy. If the sister died within 2 months after childbirth or end of a pregnancy, the interviewer asks how many days after childbirth or the end of a pregnancy the sister died. The interviewer then asks additional questions to determine whether the death was accidental or due to violence. Finally, maternal deaths are statistically rare. This means that many women need to be interviewed in order to produce reliable estimates of maternal mortality. For example, during the 2016 Uganda DHS, only 149 maternal deaths to sisters were reported for the 7-year period before the survey, during interviews with more than 18,000 women. Why does maternal mortality matter? Complications during pregnancy and childbirth are a leading cause of death and disability among women of reproductive age in developing countries, though the vast majority of maternal deaths are preventable. The maternal mortality ratio is used to measure progress in achieving the Sustainable Development Goals, or SDGs. The third SDG is to ensure healthy lives and promote well-being at all ages. Target 3.1 is the reduction of the global maternal mortality ratio to less than 70 deaths per 100,000 live births by 2030. The maternal mortality ratio is SDG indicator 3.1.1. Remember that the MMR is a ratio. In a ratio, the denominator does not include the numerator. In the simplest terms, the denominator of the MMR is the total number of live births in the reference period. The numerator is the number of maternal deaths in the same reference period. The result is then multiplied by 100,000 for the standard measure because the numerator is much smaller than the denominator. In practice, the MMR is calculated by dividing the maternal mortality rate by the general fertility rate for the same reference period. As described earlier, the maternal mortality rate is maternal deaths per 1,000 women age 15 to 49. The general fertility rate is births per 1,000 women age 15 to 49. In this division, the denominators of the two rates and the factors of 1,000 will cancel out, so in effect, the maternal deaths have been divided by the births. The result is then multiplied by 100,000 for the standard measure. In DHS final reports, you can typically find the maternal mortality ratio in the table titled Maternal Mortality Ratio. This table is from the 2016 Uganda DHS. The subtitle of the table specifies the reference period, the 7 years before the survey. The maternal mortality ratio can be found in the row labeled Maternal Mortality Ratio. The 2016 Uganda DHS estimates a maternal mortality ratio of 336 deaths per 100,000 live births. You can see that, in addition to the national estimate of 336, the table also presents the confidence interval, a range of values that are consistent with the sampling variation. The 95% confidence interval, abbreviated CI, for the 2016 Uganda DHS MMR estimate ranges from 272 to 401 deaths per 100,000 live births. This means that we're confident that if every woman in Uganda were interviewed, it's very likely that the maternal mortality ratio would be somewhere in the range of 272 to 401 deaths per 100,000 live births. To learn more about confidence intervals and interpreting trends, check out our video on this topic. You may have noticed that the MMR is only estimated at the national level. This indicator is not presented by background characteristics such as region. The number of women that would need to be interviewed to produce MMR estimates by background characteristics is too large, so DHS final reports only present a national estimate.
How to use maternal mortality ratio in a sentence. Maternal mortality ratio is a ratio, so you must use both units, women and live births, when using it in a sentence. You can say the maternal mortality ratio in Uganda is 336 deaths per 100,000 live births.
For more information about the maternal mortality ratio, visit our website, the user forum, or watch our additional videos on this indicator.